train, on the board life's train. We're not sure where we're going, we're gonna get there just the same. There'll be a few twists and turns and a few mountain peaks. We're also great to find every now and then.
The only way to see this city, it is awesome.
You can look out, enjoy the scenery, go complain all along the way. This is the ride of this, or give thanks for each today.
Okay, we're in a car today traveling on the S6 Expressway, and these new roads are very much like the Autobahn in Germany, except there are speed limits. Expressways in Poland, indicated by this sign, have a maximum speed limit of 120 kilometers an hour, while motorways, indicated by this sign, have a maximum speed limit of 140 kilometers an hour. And if you don't know what type of road you're on, look to see what color backgrounds the signs have. Green road signs indicate expressways, and blue signs indicate motorways. And when there is a change to either the expressway or the motorway as it is about to come to an end, you'll see one of these signs. Just remember, there are speed limits. Okay, we're exiting the expressway into a roundabout or traffic circle. And these are everywhere, and we love them in Europe because they move a lot of traffic very efficiently and quickly without stoplights. So this road we're on now, as we enter the city of Kołobrzeg, it's gonna seem like there's a lot of potholes, as you can see, and the road is very uneven. But don't be discouraged, because there are many roads throughout this country that are in the process of being repaved and re-engineered. So don't lose hope or feel like you're going to be having a rough ride everywhere. That is not the case. We found some amazing, smooth, new roads, and it's just been awesome. So as we enter the port area, on our left-hand side is the marina. You can see a sailboat mast and the bridge that I wanted to go over, but there's a problem with the railroad control arm, so we're going to have to go down to the next street and take a left. So here we are. You can see snow is piled up, and they've got quite a bit here in Kołobrzeg. Just down on our right is where we stayed in a penthouse Airbnb for 30 days after we had to move from another Airbnb after 15 days. So we spent a total of 45 days in Kołobrzeg as COVID was first breaking out in the country and we went into lockdown. Parking is free on the weekend. So that's a nice thing about visiting Kołobrzeg, is you don't have to pay for parking. So that's an awesome deal. As you can see, even though it's -5 and there's snow piled up everywhere, there are cars from Sweden, Germany, all parts of Poland. People come here from everywhere, lots of tourists. The weather is not a discourager, so sometimes it can be difficult to find a place because this is just a beautiful port city. We're going to keep driving just a little bit further, looking for a place a little bit closer to our favorite fish restaurant, Taverna Pacifica. So, almost there. We love coming to this resort town in the off season because it's quiet. You can hear the waves, water lapping, seagulls, ducks, and yet there are still visitors and people are respectful. Everyone just enjoys the beauty and each other, so it doesn't really matter what time of the year you come. There's pretty much going to be a lot of people, and parking is a premium. So It might be worth a trip around the block, or it might just want to take the first space that you come to, which we're looking for right across from the restaurant, and it looks like we have found one. All right.
And life goes on in Kowabjik, snow, pandemia, mask. You got it.
Well, another thing we love about this port city is the fact that you never know what you're going to find when you arrive. And today, it looks like we found a search and rescue boat from Gdynia, which is on the northeastern part of Poland. It's closer to Gdansk, and it's about 3.5 to 4 hours away by car, so this boat has made quite a little journey around the northern tip of Poland, and I'm sure the waters in this area are happy to have this search and rescue boat and crew, because the ice and the weather has been something else. Like I said, you never know what you're going to find when you come to Kowabjik down at the harbor. You might find a military ship, ships from other countries, or today, looks like we've got Monica, which is a tourist slash passenger ship that takes people out to the Baltic on quick rides. And she is docked here pretty much year-round, so if you come, you can easily get a ride see some of the coastline and what it's like out in the Baltic for yourself. Okay, well, you can see from the ice floating in the water that, needless to say, it's cold outside. We've been out here snapping pics, and we just really need to get inside to warm up. Our hands feel like they're frozen.
Alrighty, got a few quick snaps of the amazing harbor. And now we're gonna go get some amazing fried cod. Delicious.
So it's the day before Valentine's Day, February 13th, and we've just gotten our to-go meals of sour cabbage, fries, and two huge pieces of beer-battered fried cod from Taverna Pacific. And we're going to head over to the western side of the port and park and have a quick bite to eat. Sorry we didn't show you those amazing meals. It's very cold, and filming and eating in the car is just a little bit challenging. So you'll have to come back with us post-COVID and warm temps so you can see their beautiful food.
Well, this is my first time being at a beach with, gosh, that looks like about a foot. Yeah,
That's about 12 inches of snow over there. So, got here right as the sun is preparing to set. It's a beautiful park. And if you're a history person, that's a bunker right there from World War II. So it's been closed off, filled in most of the front, but that's a complex of bunker system over there, which is just amazing.
It's cold and we're going to head back now. But before we do, we want to leave you with one of the prettiest sunsets we've ever seen across the color spectrum. Put Poland on your travel list. We think you'll be glad you did.